started soon.
Let's not dilly-dally.
Yes, sir. We go.
Baratas.
No me merece la pena.
No hacemos.
How long will this hanging take, man? Don't mean to hang about all day for the captain.
We can't say anything, sir. Captain Mendoza needs only to hang the man, then he will deliver your payment.
I don't want the alleys, mind. I want goods, things I can sell, tobacco, rum, sugar.
Much fine sugar. Great, we took off a fat Englishman last night.
Englishman?
Sugar from Barbados. Very fine. We hold it in the casino. The man started to fight last night. He ran, left his sugar behind. Very fine.
Well, that's a start. Shall I accompany him to the Castillo?
No, sir. Captain Mendoza will have it sent to you, I believe. You will see.
Good Lord. Is that big brute your Captain Mendoza?
No, sir. He is El Tiburón. El Tiburón, Governor Torres' man.
¿Dónde estabas destinado antes de venir aquí?
Una pregunta para ti. ¡Vuelve! ¡Volveremos por las malas!
¡Detente! ¡Es inútil! ¡No escaparás!
¡Pararlo!
algo ahí.
¡Sacaré las tripas!
Thank you. Sorry about the sugar. I've only one pair of hands.
Oh, it's no great loss. I've got plenty of cargo here to make a profit on my trip.
Will you stay here long?
For a few weeks, yes. Then back to Barbados, to the tedium of domesticity.
Don't settle for tedium. Sail for Nassau. Live life as you see fit.
Haven't I heard that Nassau is crawling with pirates? Seems a very tawdry place.
Not tawdry, liberated.
Oh, God. That would be an adventure. But no. No, I'm a husband and a father. I have responsibilities. Life can't be all pleasure and distraction, Duncan.
Hey, our bonnet. The name's Edward, in truth. Duncan's only a handle.
Ah. Secret name for your secret meeting with the governor.
The governor, right. I think I've kept him waiting long enough.
Hasta otra vez.
Eso es algo que no se ve mucho.
Mataron a 5. ¿Cómo no? A esa distancia.
¡Quieto ahí! ¿Intentas pasarte de listo? Veamos tus tripas.
Come on, I'll be satisfied yet.
That's Diaz. Mr. Duncan Walpole of England to see the governor. I believe he is expecting me.
Sí, señor Walpole. Entre, por favor.
¿Ese es el hombre? ¿El... cómo lo llamabas? ¿Asesino?
Sí, Duncan Walpole. Debería haber llegado hace muchos días.
No me gusta que los extranjeros se paseen por nuestra ciudad. No me fío de ellos.
Cállate. El gobernador tiene invitados. Todos franceses e ingleses.
Parece un hombre rudo. Le suponía un aspecto más...
Llévame ese en alta mar. Sé indulgente con él.
Got my two best pairs of matched pistols, Duncan, so handle them with care.
If I had eight, I'd treat each as my own son.
Pull off a few shots if you like. Get a feel for it.
I once fought beside a man who carried nine on his face. They were a boom in battle, but hindered his ability to swim, sadly.
Quite. Kick, yes?
I long for the day where one firearm carries four bullets, and not the opposite.
A friend in England you may like to meet, Julian. James Puckle. He's working on something extraordinary.
Magnifique.
All right. Here's a simple challenge. Try to strike every target before this hourglass empties. Remember, hit every target within the allotted time.
Duncan. Two blades, as is the custom, eh?
Custom, aye.
Duncan, will you indulge us with a demonstration of your techniques?
Well, we must. We put together a training course in anticipation of your arrival. It would be a shame to leave here without seeing you in action. Yes, of course. Well, I mean, if there is time, I would gladly, show you what I know.
Here. You see, the situation is well suited to your skill.
Have a go! Letting the crowd is always the simplest. The grandiose, just quick and clean.
Show us another technique.
Quite ingenious to use bales of hay for cover, don't you think?
The assassins have trained you well, Duncan. You chose a perfect time to leave them behind.
At great risk, I imagine. Betraying... Thank you.
ever good for one's health.
Well, neither is drinking liquor, but I am drawn to its dangers all the same. And what is your business here, sir? Are you an associate of the governor's, or a pending acquaintance like myself?
Guns, blades, cannons, grenados, anything that may kill a man, I am happy to provide.
A smuggler of sorts.
And how is your wife these days, Captain Rogers? Is she, here, in Havana?
I trust she's well, but I wouldn't know. I've been in Madagascar some 14 months hunting pirates. It took some work to dislodge the criminals there, but we managed it. In future, I hope to use these same tactics throughout the West Indies.
And how did you deal with that kind?
Very simply. Most pirates are as ignorant as apes. I merely offered them a choice. Take a pardon and return to England, penniless, but free men. Or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Oh. I imagine Nassau would be your next target.
Very astute, Duncan, indeed.
Best of luck with that.
Grandmaster Torres!
Convened at last, and in such continental company. Decades ago, the Council entrusted me with the task of locating in these West Indies a forgotten place our precursors once called the Observatory. See here. Look upon these images and commit them to memory. They tell a very old and important story. For two decades now, I have endeavored to locate this Observatory, a place rumored to contain a tool of incredible utility and power. It houses a kind of armillary sphere, if you like. A device that would grant us the power to locate and monitor every man and woman on Earth, whatever their location. Only imagine what it would mean to have such a power. With this device, there would be no secrets among men. No lies, no trickery. Only justice, pure justice. This is the Observatory's promise, and we must take it for our own.
Do we know its whereabouts?
For in our custody is the one man who does, a man named Roberts, once called a sage.
It has been 45 years since anyone has seen a true sage. Can you be sure this one is authentic?
We are confident he is.
The assassins will come for him.
Indeed they will. But thanks to Duncan and the information he has delivered, the assassins won't be a problem for much longer. All will be made clear tomorrow, gentlemen, when you meet the sage for yourselves. Until then, let us drink. Let us find the Observatory together. For with its power... Rest well, Duncan. Tomorrow the treasure fleet arrives, and with it, your reward. After which we will discuss further schemes.
I look forward to it.
Excelente. Meet me down at the docks first thing tomorrow morning.
Governor Torres requests your presence at the docks near the Castillo. First thing tomorrow morning.
El caballero está nervioso.
¡Alto! Quiero hablar contigo.
¡Un carterista! ¡Detenedlo!
Good morning, Duncan. Just over here.
Such a fuss over one man. Is the observatory really such a grand prize?
Sin duda. The observatory was a tool built by the precursor race. Its worth is without measure.
Precursor race? I see.
One of your early letters mentioned the desire to kill the Mayan mentor, Atabai. Were you able to carry out this contract before coming here?
I was not, no. Too many complications along the way.
A pity. But the maps you delivered with the blood vial will see that job finished.
Fine. That's the idea.
I don't like this room, Forrest. We're exposed. Something is off. Stay close, Grandmaster.
I feel it.
You do not let them get their hands on the thing, whatever comes.
Assassins! Above! They're on the rooftops!
Watch the streets and alleys. They could be anywhere.
You're a nimble one, I'll give you that. Hang back and make this easy on both of us, mate. Stop, or I'll kneecap you! Ugh.
Well done, lapdog.
Quiet.
We'll see him to the prisons, Grandmaster.
Double the watch.
Well, I'll be buggered. What an active day we've had, gents.
See, he's set on all sides by our enemies. We must be more cautious.
I do wish I could remain to see our drama done, but I must avail myself of these winds and sail for England.
By all means, Captain, speed and fortune to you.
With luck, I'll return myself a governor. And with my idiot king's blessing, no less. Adios.
As for you, Mr. Walpole, I consider this the first payment in a long-term investment. Gracias.
Obliged.
I would like you to be present for the interrogation tomorrow. Call around noon.
Yes, sir.
Have a toast.
God shank me for this pittance. 1,000 reals for the...
Hey, para! te...
¡Tu vida ha terminado!
¡Puedo hacerlo!
¡Prepare, tío!
¡Rendimos fácilmente!
¡Basta ya!
What is your true name, Rogue?
It's Captain Pissoff.
Bien que pauvre Pissoff.
Where is this sage? Did you set him free?
I had nothing to do with that. Much as I wish I did.
Take him to the ports.
Send him to Sevilla with the treasure fleet.
Wait now! I delivered your treasures, didn't I?
You did, yes. But you robbed us of Duncan Wallow.
A despicable display. This tusspot is a ruined man, Caroline. Unfit for life on land, much less at sea. If he goes to the West Indies, it's you who'll suffer.
Father! Father! Come, love. Up with you now.
That old muckworm! He's wrong about me!
I hope it's so.
You believe me, don't you? Can you not see me? Standing out there on the deck of a ship that's sliding into port. And there I am, a man of quality. With 1,000 doubloons spilling from my pockets. Like drops of rain, I can see it.
La cena! ¡Cómetela rápido!
You hungry?
Now what's your plan, mate? Unlucky lads. Christ, the seas are uneasy today. Hurricane? Jesus.
We're stealing a brig. Hey, take what you need.
Won't be a minute.
Prisoners held on these ships. Set them free, and they'll sail with us, no question.
So that's the idea, then. Free what men we can, then find a fast ship to flee in.
Aye, there's a brig in this fleet. I'll make my way to it.
There's a catch to this favor. You're sailing with me.
I'd follow you to hell for this, mate.
Quieto ahí, pronto estará aquí.
Nos está retrasando. Ya deberíamos haber hecho la mitad de la ruta a las Bermudas.
Oro, plata, jade, tabaco, lo que se te ocurra.
¿Y agua qué? ¿Con comida? Me ocupa más mi estómago que las arcas.
¡Para!
Come on, lads. If we're to drown today, it won't be here. There's a brig nearby just waiting for us to take her.
¡Alto ahí!
Esto es una locura.
Calma.
¡Alto! Intenta escapar. ¿A dónde crees que vas?
Going topside. Be ready.
Lads! Save your singing for Davy Jones, you juggabots! It's a hard wind coming!
The man speaks true, you lot weigh anchor. As for the rest, half on the foremast and half at the main. Keep watch on those galleons. See they don't give us.
Incoming fire! Incoming fire! Fire!
direct hit, and we're put a team.
Water spot, man! Still ice!
It's not looking good.
Steady as she goes, man!
On those galleons. See, they don't give us trouble.
They won't. Far too slow for this weather.
Not looking good.
Steady as she goes, man. Look, water devil, sir.
Stand by, Captain.
My God, we pulled this one straight from the teeth of Neptune. I'm Edward. Much thanks for your aid back there.
Adewale.
Ever been to Nassau, Adewale?
Not yet.
By God, she took some knocks, didn't she? I think I'll keep her.
All hands aft, lads! Taking this one home.
I've made my choice, Addy. I spied a few items in the hold earlier. Powder and a few pistols. Think I'll fashion a second holster if I can.
That's a good start.
One you find laughable.
Could we talk a moment about the condition of the ship?
What's the trouble?
I had a walk about the gun deck this morning, and couldn't stand for what I saw. A clutter of linstocks heaped like tinder, and one with a slow match still burning.
Christ.
And just nearby, two barrels of gunpowder, closer than man and wife. Fit to explode at the touch of a spark.
We'll stow ours good and proper.
As for the cannons, they might as well be tossed. Clogs, touch holes in need of scraping, corrosion on the bodies, barrel swabs as naked as knives, and breech ropes so rotted, I could use them for knitting yarn. The short of it is, we need good equipment kept in fine condition. But we cannot win every battle with snares and shouts. So worry about your own armaments when it suits you. But don't forget about your jackdaw as well.
No, indeed. We'll make it a point to keep this ship and its crew in fine condition.
Then a great big Dutchman rammed my bow.
We're beelining for the rock, sir!
For a great big Dutchman rammed my bow and said, "Young man, this is mine Frau!"
I spied a few items in the hold earlier. Powder and a few pistols. I think I'll fashion a second holster if I can.
It's a good start.
One you find laughable.
Could we talk a moment about the condition of the ship?
What's the trouble?
I had a walk about the gun deck this morning, and couldn't stand for what I saw. A clutter of linstocks heaped like tinder, and one with a slow match still burning.
Christ.
And just nearby, two barrels of gunpowder, closer than man and wife. Fit to explode at the touch of a spark.
We'll stow ours good and proper.
As for the cannons, they might as well be tossed. Clogs, touch holes in need of scraping, corrosion on the bodies, barrel swabs as naked as knives, and breech ropes so rotted, I could use them for knitting yarn. The short of it is, we need good equipment kept in fine condition. But we cannot win every battle with snares and shouts. So worry about your own armaments when it suits you. But don't forget about your jackdaw as well.
No, indeed. We'll make it a point to keep this ship and its crew in fine condition.
Turn the mains! Reef those gallons! Ahoy, Captain. Find what you need.
My needs and wants are oceans apart, mate. But I did fashion myself a new holster. All I need now is a pistol to lie in it.
Yeah. Taken from the holds, just as you said.
A little more than a blowpipe. But it'll do. So, are we rested? Or should we idle a while longer?
Best way anchor. I think the crew is itching to reach civilization.
You'll find no civilization in Nassar. But it's a fine place to be merry all the same.
Captain Queernabs, tell me I'm under arrest.
Tell me!
Them your breads.
Fly away, boyo, back to your master.
Aye, we was privateers together before the wars ended. I'll see you ashore.
You're a sight for salty eyes.
Send any men you find to the Jackdaw. I'll put them to work.
Cheers, Addy.
Hey.
Here.
Over there.
Maybe we save the king some coins and simply cut you down, maggot.
I do not know who you... Captain Kenway, just in time. I'll see you back aboard.
Sending you both on your merry ways.
What's your game? Up there.
Guards, we're losing ground!
I'll take your scully.
Fish in a barrel, mate. Faster! We'll not be losing it!
Hey!
Aye.
Can't get away, corpse. Lads, let it be.